into what we call our school closings list. We do this at the beginning of every show, so we'll go through. These are the updates to the changes in schedules and now vaccination and masking policies. And we've got a few cancellations going on this weekend virtually, though, for those of you who are interested in finding something online. Gen Con in Indianapolis, Fan X Salt Lake in Salt Lake City, Utah, and AlbaCon in Albany, New York. All of those have online components this weekend while they're doing, while they're doing the physical in-person event. We do have one that has decided to go virtual, NorwestCon Mini in Seattle, Washington, scheduled for November 6th and 7th. They are going online. And then we have the cancellations. Comic-Con Russia in Moscow, Queen City Comic-Con in Charlotte, North Carolina, RealmsCon in Corpus Christi, Texas, Fangia, San Diego, California, Hamilton Con up in Ontario, Mid-Island Comic Show in Hicksville, New York, Red Dragon, I believe this is Red Dragon 6, this is a Hannibal convention in London, A Salute to Lucifer, Whippany, New Jersey, OzCon in Sydney, Australia, Anthro Southeast in Chattanooga, Tennessee, Infernity, New Taipei City, Taiwan, The Oak City Comic-Con in Raleigh, North Carolina, Smash in Sydney, The Lone Star Game Expo in Grapevine, Texas, outside of Dallas, VidCon Mexico in Mexico City, and the Edmonton Expo in Canada. Both of those, we do have dates for the upcoming shows in 2022, but they have gone ahead and canceled their 2021 events. And we do have a reschedule for WillCon in Williamson, West Virginia, the new date moving from the end of September. I believe September 25th was their original date. They are now at November 13th in the hopes that they can still move forward with an event this year. All right, here are the events requiring masks, and we specify the masks required on this list because this is mask up whether you've got a vaccination or not. Our vaccination list is a different one. So here we go. Monsterama in Atlanta, Georgia. Made in Asia in Brussels, Belgium. Great Lakes Comic Expo Fall in Clinton Township, Michigan, October 9th. Louisville Con in Kentucky. The Clifton Comic Book Show in New Jersey, October 10th. Rhode Island Comic Con up in Providence. Anime Banzai in Salt Lake City, Utah. Icon in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Tokyo in Tulsa in Oklahoma, October 15th through the 17th. The Fayetteville Comic Con in Arkansas. Chizu Con in Madison, Wisconsin, October 16th. Oddities and Curiosities in Portland, Oregon, also on the 16th of October. Spooky Empire down in Orlando. Another anime convention in Nashua, New Hampshire. HowlCon in Halifax, Nova Scotia, October 22nd through the 24th. And then TFCon, the Transformers Convention, in Baltimore, Maryland. And then Roseville Comic-Con Swap Meet in Georgia. SpoCon in Spokane. Astronomicon in Rochester, New York. Fanboy Expo, Knoxville, Tennessee, October 29th through the 31st. Now, a couple of other Fanboy Expos canceled. This one is moving forward at this time. OniCon in Galveston, Texas. Comic-Con Brussels in Brussels, Belgium. King Kong Northwest in Renton, Washington. SciFiCon Mini in Lake Charles, Louisiana. Oddities and Curiosities in Seattle, October 30th. Flower City Comic-Con in Rochester. Do I have that on there twice? I do believe I do. Nashville Con. I think I've got those on there twice. That's what happens when you put these lists together at 3 o'clock in the morning. All right, so requiring vaccinations. We've got quite a few of those this week. Alamo City Furry Invasion, San Antonio. A lot of these events are going to require either a vaccination proof or a negative test. Most of them are going with 72-hour tests. Some of them are going with 24 hours. So check your websites if you're planning to go to these. Fantasy Basel in Switzerland, October 8th through the 10th. They're taking either a proof of vaccination, a negative test, or a previous positive diagnosis. And as we mentioned last week, we're starting to see a few of these pop up, events acknowledging that this is another option that's becoming something to look at. San Diego WHOCON, vaccination card or negative tests, and they are requiring masks as well. Western Pennsylvania Furry Weekend, Allison Park, Pennsylvania. And I forgot to put the dates on those. Comic-Con Quebec, they are requiring proof of vaccination and masks. Enchanted in Birmingham, UK, they'll take a vaccination card or a negative test. They're also requiring masks. Metaverse in Atlanta is requiring vaccinations. And also, since the vaccinations are not available to people under 12, they're saying that nobody under 12 can attend. And everybody's got a mask up. Atlanta Game Fest in Alpharetta, Georgia. Biggest Little Fur Con in Reno, Nevada. They are requiring proof of vaccination, and they want you to sign a liability waiver and mask up. And then moving to this other list here, Anime Fusion in Plymouth, Minnesota. They do have a virtual option available if you want to spring for a less expensive ticket, but they are requiring vaccinations for everybody. FedCon in Dusseldorf, Germany, doing it a little bit differently. They are requiring either proof of vaccination, proof of recovery if you had the virus, and a 48-hour negative test plus the masks. Mrs. Boss, on FedCon in Germany, just off the top of my head, are they requiring the 48-hour negative test in addition to proof of they've had it before? Okay, she's going to double-check on that. Anime Weekend in Atlanta, vaccination or negative test. Same for DerpyCon in New Brunswick, New Jersey. Snafu in Reno, Nevada, same thing. Frightmare in the Falls, proof of vaccination and masking up. Big Apple Comic-Con in New York, also requiring vaccinations. Now, in these instances where we're just listing the event, as far as our notes go, they are only requiring a vaccination. They don't have any notes that we found so far about whether or not masks are going to be required in addition to that. One would assume that since all of them are vaccinated, that they may do away with that. But you know what happens when you assume. All right, last few on this. Bath Comic-Con in the UK, vaccination or negative test. And then there's ValleyCon in Fargo, North Dakota, October 14th through the 17th. They are going with the state of North Dakota and Cass County health guidelines, which essentially says if you haven't been vaccinated, they request and recommend that you wear a mask, but it's not required. If you have been vaccinated and you want to wear a mask, then you can, but you don't have to. And they are making it clear that they are not going to be asking for your proof of vaccination. They're saying on their website that it's between you and your doctor, and it's none of their business. So there is that. Now, as we're continuing to monitor all of this, and yes, Mazer, YouTube is working. We're not pre-recorded, and we did... I talked about it earlier on Live from the Bunker about what we figured out on that. If you are involved in an event, whether as a volunteer or an organizer, you want to send us some information to let us know what your policies are going to be, what your schedule is like, you can send us an email, events@scififorme.com, or you can go over to the conventions page on the main website and make sure that your event is listed. And Mrs. Boss, did you find that? Do I need to vamp?
I'm still looking.
Okay, we're still looking. We'll come back to it. In the meantime, we are monitoring emails and social media posts and websites and various different things about making sure that we have the current information as much as we can. So there is that. Now, real quick, with regard to New York Comic-Con, Funimation made an announcement. They're going to have an immersive anime experience in addition to a couple of panels at New York. Funimation Sakura Park is what they're calling it. They're going to have a branded food truck there, photo opportunities with various different backgrounds, and some faux cherry blossom trees. They'll have exclusive giveaways you can sign up for, and of course, the Funimation shop will be set up if you want to spend money. The panels that they've got planned, My Hero Academia and Demon Slayer, Kimetsu no Yaiba, they'll be posting updates on their social media and the YouTube channels for anybody who's not able to attend. Also, Demon Slayer, the Mugen Train movie, hits Blu-ray December 24th. And while Mrs. Boss is still looking that up, let me add that one of the things that we do here that it doesn't seem anybody else does is we help you plan for the weekends where you are going to an event. Justin, good morning. Well, good afternoon for you. He says, probably you don't know about the sci-fi fantasy Vilda Universer in Aarhus, Denmark on the 9th of October, 2021. We will make a note. That doesn't sound familiar to me. So you have a...
I do.
Okay. Sure. All right.
Mic is on. All right. In regards to FedCon, it is a vaccination certificate of full vaccination protection, confirmation of a recovery, or a negative test that is not older than 48 hours.
Okay. So that's an or, not an and.
Yes. And right. I'm just going to throw this out there for anybody who does conventions and, you know, is trying to keep everybody up to date. Please try to make this information easier to find.
Yes, we need big giant button on the website that says, here's our COVID-19 policy.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Okay.
Thanks.
All right, thank you. All right, now as part of our coverage here, something nobody else does is the weather forecast for the events that are hosting different events. And we do this every week. So here is the forecast for next weekend's events worldwide.